I'm Denise Hardesty, and I'm a research scientist for CSIRO, and I'm running a national marine debris project. And that project is a fantastic partnership between Shell, Earthwatch, and CSIRO. So one of the key things that we'll be doing out of this project and out of this research is basically developing sort of a ribbon plot or a map all the way around the country. You know, we're surveying every 100 kilometers. School groups are contributing and filling in gaps for us where we don't have information. And we'll basically have a map all the way around the country of what does our marine debris or coastal debris look like. And by having that information, we can really use that to make the appropriate decisions at the council levels, at the state levels, and at the federal levels, so that we're having science informing our policy and decision makings around Australia. This is the first and only project of this scale that's ever been done anywhere in the world where we're actually using a really consistent scientific methodology, this approach going all the way around Australia. So for this project, we have three main goals or objectives. One is to develop a list of the species that are most likely and least likely to be impacted by the threat of marine debris. So what are those species that tend to eat it more, get tangled up in it more, and what are those effects at the, not just the individual level, but at the population at the species level? We're interested in really having people have the ability to make decisions. So whether that's individuals and consumers and how they're making decisions about the products that they use, and also to be able to inform policymakers. And so that hopefully the understanding that the learnings that we get from this marine debris project can be used to inform not just scientists and the research that we're doing, but also to inform local, state, and federal policy decisions as they're made. You know, the idea is to be published not just in scientific journals and that sort of thing, but really importantly, we're going to be reaching out into the communities. And really, it can be very simple changes in decisions that we make as consumers that may have a tremendous effect or impact on what we find out there in the marine environment and what we're finding along Australia's beaches. So one of the key aspects of this project is that we're working with citizen scientists. We're working with school groups and teachers and other groups who have had interest from scout groups and others like that. And they're working with around the country to contribute to this national database. And that's a really exciting opportunity for us because we simply cannot get everywhere with such a vast 37,000 kilometer coastline. So we're working with teachers and schools to go out and to collect data with us in a scientific fashion. They know that they're contributing to something at a national scale, that data is really being used by scientists. And importantly, all of the work that we're doing fits into the national science curriculums. This project doesn't require a lot of resources, you know, a meter tape and a map and access to a beach or to a coastal area is all that it really takes. That in a bag, of course, to go and pick up and collect the rubbish that they're finding along the way. So here we are, we're getting ready to deploy the net over the side. So let's go ahead and get it going so we can get those debris surveys. So these trawls run at the ocean surface so that we can get information on the floating debris that we're getting in different areas. So some of the information that we're collecting with the trawl nets is really to figure out where the debris is out in the marine environment. Because with our coastal surveys, we're using oceanographic models to hindcast and say, okay, where does that debris accumulate? Where is it out in the open ocean? And by understanding that and understanding where the birds and the turtles, et cetera, are feeding and making their living out at sea, that actually allows us to overlay. So where are the birds or the marine mammals or the turtles, whatever we're looking at, where is that marine debris out in the open ocean? And the way to get that information into sort of ground truth or to proof and to check the oceanographic models is to actually go out in the ocean, go out and collect some information by running trawls at a series of locations around the country. So I'm really lucky. I have one of the best jobs in the world. I'm getting to go around all of Australia's coastline, and I'm in stunning beaches and really remote beaches where we have to bushwalk to get through to places where you don't find much in the way of human habitation, to actually surveying beaches in the middle of cities. So I'm getting to these parts of the country, some that are really remote, where you don't expect to find rubbish, but we're still finding human debris all around the country.
I mean, I really think that people, after they're involved in this and collecting a little bit of data, they won't go to a beach and not look down and not pick up that rubbish that we're finding in all of our coastal areas. I would challenge anyone to go to any beach anywhere in Australia, no matter how remote, and not find some bits of human rubbish.